Get ready to match the stars. Bert Convy, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Lee Meriwether, Richard Dawson, and Gail Fisher as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now, here's the host of Match Game 74, Gene Raver.
Hello, Johnny Olson. I guess everybody had a good day yesterday watching the Rose Bowl parade on CBS and watching all the bowl games and all that, and how here we are into where we are. Anyway, and they said it wouldn't last, and here we are in Match Game 74, and we thank you all for joining us, and you especially, because we couldn't do it without you. You're a gifted
Look what
bunch.
I found from last
you found a little
year.
Heart at your chair. See how I feel about you? All right, let's say hello to our two players, Harry Reynolds and Paula Arbaugh. Hello, players. Harry's a current champ. He's won two games, has a total of $450 to his credit. How do you feel about that, Harry?
Pretty good.
Beats losing.
Right.
How do you feel about that, Paula?
Well, he's got four, I got two. Now
well,
all I need
right.
is four, right?
Right.
And he needs none.
You're going to put the evil eye on him.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Well, we're going to finish this game with round two, I guess it is, right after we pass along this message to you. Here we go with round two, folks. Going to finish this game. Final round. Paula, it's up to you to make a selection.
A again.
She wants A. Last time out, you match Richard and Charles, so the two of you will not participate. Everyone else will, and this is it. Mary said, John, that wasn't the garbage you just threw out. That was my blank. Mary said that to John. That wasn't the garbage you just threw out. That was my blank. You can take a little nap while you're waiting there. Just doze off for a minute.
I thought he'd been sleeping all week.
Okay.
I'm ready.
Ready. Here we go. Paula, Mary said, John, that wasn't the garbage you just threw out. That was my...
Oh, dinner.
Dinner. I think that's a good answer. You think that's a good answer? Let's see if it scores for her. Bert, let's see if she matches you.
I said lunch.
Aw. Can't match lunch and dinner. Sorry about that. Brett.
I didn't come anywhere near food. I said mother.
No, audience, now listen, don't laugh at her. We have to book one weirdo on every show. She's a resident weirdo there.
Take a weirdo to lunch and or dinner.
Okay, now, Paula, you must match Lee and Gail to stay in the game. Lee, may we see yours? She's looking for the word dinner.
I know, but this happened to me once. My girdle.
Girdle! So Harry wins another game. Congratulations. Okay. Well, Paula, we've enjoyed meeting you. We wish you the very best of luck in 74.
Thank you.
We've got a gift for you, together with our thanks for being on Match
Game
74.
Thank you, and I had a good time.
Bye-bye.
Paula Arbaugh.
Goodbye, Paula. Well, Harry, how do you feel about it?
Good.
You stick with those one-word answers, don't you? You told me a little earlier, one of the answers that came up here was social studies, and he teaches social studies, and never thought of it occurred to him to say it. Let's see what happens now. We polled a recent studio audience, Harry, and we got their best response to this. Blank bond. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500, see if you can match it. The second, $250, and the third, $100. Now, which three celebrities would you like to get a little assist from?
Bert. Oh,
Bert Convy.
Yes, scared me to death. I was writing.
Blank Bond.
James Bond.
There's one for you. Brett.
How about
Brett?
War Bond, you little devil?
War Bond.
Now pay attention this time, Harry.
And Charles.
I don't have one.
Blank Bond.
James and War were the only ones I could think of.
Government Bond.
Same Government well. Bond. Was he too late with that? That's okay. Government bond.
I mean,
bond.
If that loose the rules, that's okay?
Yes.
Government bond.
All right, now you may choose one of those. James Bond, War Bond, or Government Bond.
Oh, I meant Savings Bond. I didn't actually mean War Bond.
You meant Savings Bond? Well, War Bond is what you said, and that's the one we're going to have to go with. Sorry, Brett.
Well, sorry, Brett. I'll take Savings Bond.
You're pretty sneaky, aren't you, Brett? Okay, Savings Bond is what he says is up there somewhere, preferably in the $500 position for him. Let us find out right now, first by revealing the $100 response. U.S. Savings Bond it is, and there it is right off the bat. Congratulations. Okay. I don't know what's under the other two, but I think we ought to find out right now.
I'd love to.
You think James Bond is under there somewhere?
James,
let's see if he's under the $250 response.
James.
Bail Bond is there. You could use that. Well, I don't know. James Bond has got to be there somewhere.
Right.
James Bond, where are you? Come out wherever you are. Are you under the $500 response? Yes, he is. There you are. Okay. Well, Harry, you've won the $100. Means you'll play for 10 times that amount or $1,000. To collect, you got to match one celebrity head-to-head exactly. Which one will it be?
Bert.
Okay, Bert, you get ready to write. Harry will face me. Here's the $1,000 question. Blank post. B-O-S-T. Blank post. Bert's finished his answer, Harry. Now it's up to you to give us your response, see if you can match him. Blank post. What do you put in the blank?
Emily.
Emily Post, he says. Bert, for $1,000, may we see your answer?
Geez, so many posts. I was thinking bowl time, I said goal post. I'm sorry.
Goal post. Okay. So there's no match there. You've added to your winnings, Harry. You're up to $650. You're going to meet another challenger. Here comes Dorothy Zinni. Okay. You know Harry Reynolds, Dorothy?
Yes, I do. Hi, Harry.
How are you?
Fine, thank you. Excited.
Are you excited?
A little bit nervous.
Take a deep breath.
Okay. I'm afraid I'll pass out.
No. Let me hear you breathe, Dorothy.
I don't know if I can.
Take an inhale.
Okay. All right, I'm ready.
Okay. Well, I'm not. Dorothy, where are you from?
Granada Hills.
And what do you do?
Oh, I'm a housewife, and I have three boys.
Yeah.
They really make me nervous. This is nothing.
Get around your kids, and they shake you up a little.
Oh, you know.
Good luck to Dorothy and to Harry. Here we go. Dorothy, the challenger makes a selection, if you would, please.
Okay, B.
B is what she wants, and that's what we're going to give her. Here we go. Everybody plays.
Uh-huh.
Janet said, I've got good news and bad news. The good news is...
the story of my life.
I just found a really cheap place to live. The bad news is, it used to be a blank. Janet said that. I got good news and bad news. Good news is I found a really cheap place to live. The bad news is, it used to be a blank. By Jove, she's got it. All right. Ready down here? Ready up there?
Yeah,
spelling doesn't count. Don't worry about it. Just put it in the slot and we'll figure it out somehow.
It used to be a goalpost.
Okay, Dorothy. Janet said, I've got good news and bad news. The good news is I just found a really cheap place to live. The bad news is it used to be a...
barn.
Barn.
Oh, isn't that good?
Barn. Barn is okay.
Yeah, okay, like a stable or barn, you know.
Yeah. You like barn? You like our answer?
Yes.
Bert, what do you say?
I say a house of ill repute.
Oh.
Bert, what did you say?
I had to clean up his answer for him, you know.
Yes,
I said house of ill repute.
You did. Okay. That's two of those now.
Watch it with the buzzer now. I've warned you before.
Charles?
It's really not easy being on a floor with two people that come up with those kind of answers. I said a lovely French word, a brothel.
A brothel. Sorry, Dorothy.
Oh, I am too.
Yes.
I'm beginning to think that there's something strange between Charles and myself. I said brothel also.
Oh, yeah.
I love
that. There is something strange. Yes.
All right, Richard.
Now we have two ill reputes. Two orders of broth. Well, I have. have more, you lucky stiff.
Mon Dieu.
One more.
Hey, all right. Gail, are you ready?
Yes, I thought it would be a red light district.
Red light district.
What can you have?
Okay. Dorothy.
What did she say?
Dorothy, get her back on nighttime television. And I'm just as glad. All right. We'll get back to this game in just a moment or so. First, we got this. Okay. Shall we carry on? We are going to finish round one. Dorothy did not score a match in her end of the round. We'll see how Harry Reynolds does in his end of the round. Everyone plays. Abdul hired a girl to come in once a week to blank his bed of nails. Do you remember Abdul?
He hired this
girl to come in once a week to blank his bed of nails.
What a nerve.
Okay. All set. Harry, what did Abdul hire this girl to do once a week?
Sharpen.
To sharpen his bed of nails. Audience is with you, Harry. Let's see if the celebrities are with you.
I said to sharpen his bed of nails.
So this celebrity is with you. There's one for you. Brett?
This may appear to be a piece of trivia to you. But my daddy's name was Harry.
Yes.
And I said sharp. Oh, wait. I said sharp.
Yes, it is trivial.
You're right, it is.
Well, not to me, no, my daddy. I love my daddy.
All right, Charles.
That is the worst Southern accent I ever heard. I also said sharp.
He said sharp, too. That's three for you, Harry. You're doing very well. Lee Meriwether, the only true Southerner down here.
Go ahead.
What do you say?
I was born in Southern Los Angeles. Sharpin.
Sharpin, she says. Well, there's four for you, Harry.
Yes,
Richard,
sorry.
You're from the South of England.
Yes. Rhett and her daddy were close. When she ran away, when she got home, he had run away. Sharpin.
Sharpin. That's five for you, Harry and Gail.
I'm not going to show mine because I'm the only one that
hammered. Hammer the bed of nails, huh? Well, that's all right. Harry, you can't win them all. What the heck? Okay, now we'll go to round two. Dorothy, you've got to match five celebrities to stay in the game, and you got one shot at it here.
All right, guys, let's try B.
B. Okay. All right.
Let's try it.
She's putting you on your mettle.
Okay.
You're on notice now. This is for you and Dorothy. Everybody plays. Mrs. Goldberg said to the nurse, "Whenever Dr. Levy touches me, I get blank."
I have a name like that.
But could you do that one?
Mrs. Goldberg said to the nurse, "Whenever Dr. Levy touches me, I get blank."
I know what I want to say.
Well, say it.
No.
You can turn the whole place into a garage if you really insist on it.
All right. Okay.
I can't even read it.
All right, no, that's okay. That's fine. All finished. All right. Now, Dorothy, Mrs. Goldberg said to the nurse, "Whenever Dr. Levy touches me, I get..."
Goosebumps, chills.
Goosebumps, goose pimples, chills, or whatever.
Yeah, come on, that's good.
That's good.
I'm really hoping.
Yes, all right. Whatever her answer is, it is. Bert, what do you say?
Well, you hoped right. I said goosebumps.
There it is.
I'm in the game. I'm still in the game.
All right, you need four more to stay the game here. Brett, what do you say?
I think that poor little treasure's having a seizure. And I think that's the worst answer I've ever heard in my whole life.
Oh, no.
It's a good
one. But I said it anyway.
Goosebumps, there's another one for you. Charles?
I need three more.
Don't be so insecure, Dorothy. Honest to goodness, I said goosebumps, pimples, or flesh.
Okay.
And one of Charles's due for mine.
Why? What have you got?
Ticklish.
You got ticklish?
Yes.
Uh-oh.
Leave it to her to get racy at the wrong moment.
You got to match one of the two remaining ones to stay in the game. Richard. What? Both. Oh, you got to match them both to stay in the game.
Well, there's one she's matched.
There's one. Now it's up to Gail.
Oh, God. I don't know about this, Gail. I mean, really, I just must be stupid.
Go, baby.
Goosebumps.
There it is.
Five.
your end of the round to go yet, and we got to get to that a little bit later, but right now we've got this for you. Don't go. Okay, here we go. 5-5 is the score. We're at the second and final round. Harry, you need one match to win the game. This is it.
This is a recording.
Oh, wow.
Now, this is only for one person, and that person is Lee Meriwether.
What do you mean it's only for one person?
Now, wait a minute. Okay. Not Lee. Gail. It's Gail. I beg your pardon. Gail is the one.
Oh, the dummy on the end.
Gail, this is only for you.
What do you mean? Wait. Oh, that's
only
right.
For you and Harry.
Okay, come on, Harry. Here we go.
All right. Now,
we're going to make a little disease of our own.
That's enough eye contact.
Unbelievable.
That's enough eye contact. Hold everything now. Here it is.
Okay.
Herman's blank looks like a prune. Write an answer now.
Gail, take my advice. Don't answer it.
Gail?
Take the pick, man. Take the pick.
No. Leave her alone.
Isn't it wonderful?
I'll give the kid a chance.
Isn't it wonderful?
Leave her alone.
What was the condition of it?
No. There it is. Herman's blank looks like a prune.
Isn't it wonderful?
Oh, my.
A great show like this goes off on the second day of the new year. Bye.
Okay. Harry, Gail has finished writing her answer, and it's up to you to give us your answer. Herman's blank looks like a prune. What do you say?
Nose.
Nose. That's not a bad answer. Wait a minute now.
What did you want him to say?
We ask Gail to show us her answer now. Nose is his.
I'm so nervous, and I just didn't want to spell it, so I said face.
Face.
Oh, good. Oh, no, really, that's good for me. I'm really glad.
Did she hurt you? Did she hurt you when she hit you?
I didn't mean to.
Yeah. Kiss him right on the eye. That's it.
I just was so excited, though.
Let's not have any fighting on this show. I tell you. This girl doesn't know her own strength. She really gave him a belt there. All right, so it's 5-5. It ends in a tie. And what happens when that occurs is we just wipe the slate clean. We go to a tiebreaker here. One question for each of you. The one who has scored the most matches, move your chair over a little, Harry, will be the winner. Dorothy, would you make a selection, please?
A.
A. We're in the tiebreaker, folks. Everybody plays. This is it.
Or Dorothy will kill you.
That's right. The lady octopus said to her boyfriend, "You've sure got blank hands." The lady octopus said to her boyfriend, "You've sure got blank hands."
Well, do you mind?
I don't think too hard, just trust your instincts. We tell people here, Dorothy, to trust their first judgments, and that's usually a good idea, both in your case and in theirs. They're all finished. So Dorothy, we call on you for your response. The lady octopus said to her boyfriend, "You've sure got blank hands."
Long hands.
Long hands?
Yeah.
She has long hands.
Oh! I can't believe it!
Is they say, oh, everything. It's
audience.
A tough bunch of pleas here. I don't know who's going to say long hands up here. We'll see. Bert, long hands is her answer.
I said you've sure got clammy hands.
Clammy hands is a good answer. Brett, what did you say?
I'm so upset for Dorothy, I can't stand it. I said busy because he was another
busy.
Octopus.
Yeah, okay. Charles?
I said roaming hands.
Roaming hands. Okay,
oh,
Lee?
Dorothy,
because he was an octopus, he had a lot of hands.
A lot of hands. And Richard?
Oh, how bad.
The risk of being punched in the nose. I said wandering hands.
Hands. And Gail?
Oh, Dorothy, don't hit me, but
I won't.
I said long hands.
Long hands. Dorothy, you're breaking the whole set.
I'm really sorry.
Gotta put it back together again. This girl is really strong. We'll repair it and come back for after this message here. We'll fix it up a little bit later. Gee, I'm sorry we have to leave now.
Oh.
But we've got to leave because the time is just about up. Will you both come back next time?
Oh, yes, we'll be here.
Oh.
I'll be here.
whether you like it or not, you're coming back next time. Remember that.
And you come back, you must obey orders.
Well, sir, when we come back next time, we will have... Oh, listen.
Right to get Dorothy out of her shell. You're right to Dorothy Shellbox.
Join us next time for this galaxy of stars.
Larry Hobus, Brett Somers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Hattie Deutsch, Richard Dawson, and Madeline Rue.
Gene Rayburn for Match Game 74. Join us next time. Thank you.
Today's consolation prizes are the Weekender by American Tourister, designed to go everywhere by land, sea, or air, fiberglass reinforced construction, strong, lightweight luggage by American Tourister, and Long Nails, the amazing product that changes short, broken nails into long, beautiful, natural-looking nails for strength and glamour. Long Nails. And a supply of Swiss Miss Cocoa, delicious toffee, mocha, cinnamon, malt, and chocolate-flavored instant mixes. Just add hot water. This is Johnny Olsen speaking for Match Game 74, a Mark Goodson, Bill Totman production. Stay tuned for Secret Storm next over most of these CBS stations. This program was edited for broadcast.